Welcome back to Wasteland 2. We have finally arrived in L.A. Not exactly in the best of circumstances, given this flaming wreckage that was once our vessel of transportation. And the fact that the Santa Fe Springs that we're going to has apparently been overrun by mutant dogs. So, we should probably go help them out. Still though, this is the first step on a, well, another very long journey. In a completely new location, so I'm really excited to check out this place. See what it looks like, see what enemies to find, and friends to find, and figure out the political landscape. So, let's go. As the dust clears, you realize that you've landed in the middle of a dogfight. Literally. A ranger captain and the remnants of his team stand back to back in the center of a makeshift compound with massive mutant dogs attacking them from all sides. Wait, what? Where? Huh? Oh, there we go. Nuke Pooch? That doesn't sound good. And I just found ammo inside of a trash bag. Who in the right mind would throw out ammo? Alright, I know you're getting attacked by mutant dogs, but let me just do some exploring first. Okay, let's go help them. This place is actually bigger than I thought. Let's kill ourselves some nuke pooches. Time to poach the pooches. No time for introductions. Start blasting these dogs. Have got us by the balls. Okay. Alright, what do we have? Armor, damage. Ooh, they actually do a lot of damage. 35 to 40. 3 armor. Not a lot of hit points, though. Should easily be able to take them out with one burst of this baby. I'm surprised it could take... A freaking dog just took... Or is going to take more than 2 shots. Also, they look... I wish I could zoom in more. You probably can't see it. But these things are very mutated. They look really disgusting and disturbing. They got like super long tongues. They're like Resident Evil dogs or something. Could I kill you? I think this actually would kill you. Oh, 7 hit points left, no. Oh damn, Dave is really, really hurt. Alright, so I'm gonna go for this dog first. I can't take a knee and headshot. One normal shot is not going to do it. Let's try this. Yes! Okay, Dave should be okay. Here, go distract them. Distraction successful! Don't go for Dave, don't go for Dave. Alright, good. Alright, let's take a knee. Damn. Nice, got a crit. Let's not waste the ammo. His chance to hit is not great. Yours is much better. Let's see. Am I gonna be able to do anything with Yulia? No, she has to reload, so she won't be able to move. Kinda wanna just punch him to death with Lexicanium. You know what? In fact, I am actually going to do that. Let's save some ammo. Might even be able... Yeah, I could kill one. But no, let's punch them to death. First, I am going to punch you. And then you. loser. That's what you get for missing. You get bit in the balls by a mutant dog. Leg wound. Oh. Negative to speed. That's pretty cool. That's an appropriate status effect for getting mauled by a dog. So yeah, those dogs do a lot of damage, actually. Not a lot of hit points, but if you let them get to you, and they move pretty fast, they can do quite a bit. Alright, you don't look like you're doing too well. Let me fix you up. That did not do very much. Is he gonna stop holding his gut at some point, or... Come on, you're perfectly healthy. What, do you need painkillers or something? 5 minutes. You sons of bitches couldn't have got here 5 minutes sooner. I'm sorry. I know it's not your fault. You got here as quick as you could. It's just... Come on, killer. Cowboy up. Still got work to do. Okay, listen up, Echo One. If you don't want to see a replay of what just happened, you need to secure the perimeter of this cheese box and keep out those dogs. No, wait. First, you need to find Woodson and see if he's still alive. He was in our radio room, where that pack showed up. I'll be goddamned if I'm gonna leave the last man under my command to die. But before you go, if any of you know how to patch a wound, one of those pooches got me pretty good below the ribs. Afraid I'm gonna bleed out. I already fixed you up, you're fine. How bad is your wound? Don't know, haven't looked. Leaving red footprints. Not anymore. Alright, where's the room? Straight north from here, get going. Okay. What happened to Woodson? I probably shouldn't waste time asking. Should probably just go save him. Yeah. Let's ask him that stuff later. Yeah, let's just go. Alright. Normally I assume that nothing is actually time dependent, but in this game it actually might be. So let's go north. No smoking. Woodson. Oh shit, looks like the door's been busted down. ...58%. That's better. Alright, there's at least one dog coming from that direction. Let's just kill you. Yep, I'm coming, Woodson. I can hear you. Move her out of the way there. Headshot, probably worth it. Which dog is going next? These two? No, this one's going next. Then the one over here. Then the other one. Nice. Okay, I actually want to get Lexicanium out of here because it doesn't have much health. So, run away. You were a distraction, and now you're a liability. Alright, the dog shouldn't be able to get close enough and attack at the same time. Yeah, okay. SMG is an ideal weapon against these dogs. Which one shall I kill? I suppose it doesn't really matter, because we're definitely going to be able to kill both of them before they have a chance to have another turn. Let's do a big burst. Let's go for you. Let's shotgun it. Alright, you're good, man. You're good. Let's level up so we can get everybody healed. Oh, right! There's no contact. Well, now I really want to reestablish radio contact because I can't level up. Oh, that's... what? That's our ranger locker. I thought I only could have what I took with me. Apparently the ranger locker was, I guess, transported too? On the helicopter? That's cool. Don't have any need of this stuff, but... nice. How you doing? Lieutenant Wade Woodson, one of the most technically minded members of the Rangers. He's wearing a makeshift pair of glasses and is starting to gray at the temples. Good thing you showed up when you did. I was gonna have to go tooth and nail with those dogs if they'd made it through that door. Captain Carlson sent you? They doing okay over there? I'm sorry to say this, but they're dead. What? Only Carlson survived? The rest are dead? Oh, fuck. I thought with you here, everything would be... yeah, I get it. Too late. God damn it. I was hoping today was gonna be one big family reunion. Now it's a fucking funeral. Shit, well... well, I guess that just means it's even more important that we get to work. We don't want those poor bastards to have died in vain. Carlson's dying, he's on his last... no, he's not! I healed him up, he's fine! Congratulations on the promotion to Lieutenant. I don't know if now's the time for that. Where did the dogs come from? They've been roaming around the outskirts of this place since we got here. They've kept their distance until now. No idea what set them off. So, what is this place? Seems like it was a big water treatment plant once upon a time. Now it's just a ruin. But I think we can make it defendable if we put some work into it. Too fucking late, of course. What are you doing? Well, I gotta get this radio back in order. Before I put one in his brain, that dog tore my wires up something fierce. I'm sure Carlson's put you on the perimeter duty, patching up the holes in our defenses and killing nuke pooches. But just in case he forgot to tell you, those are our main priorities right now. Okay, now go tell Carlson I'm okay. I'll come see him in a bit. As soon as I get this radio cleaned up. Alright, congratulations on your promotion. Appreciate it. General Vargas pinned me himself right before we left for California. He told me he was proud of my work and that I'd make an excellent general someday. Rest assured, I'm gonna do my best to prove him right. Probably should have said this first, but Echo 1 reporting. Oh, you're able to give us promotions. Ah. Right, because if we had to wait to reestablish contact with Vargas, that's probably going to be a very, very long time. Because don't we need to find an appropriate place high enough up to establish permanent contact with Ranger Citadel? It's probably not going to happen for a while. Alright, thank you, sir. Proud to serve under you. I guess I'll tell him Carlson's dying, even though it's not true, just in case, I don't know. I can't believe it. Okay, he's not really dying. Okay. So, clean up the dogs. Oh, wait, what the f- I already healed you, what the hell, you just- what, did you, like, rip out the stitches and just bleed it all back out again? What the fuck, man? God. Do I have to use surgery on you? I guess he needs surgeon? To stop the bleeding or something? I don't know. Captain Carlson looks much worse. His face is pale and sweaty and his eyes are glassy. The bandage around his belly smells like rotting meat. Oh. Wait, but didn't you just get attacked like 5 minutes ago? How can you already be rotting? Perforated intestines, huh? Isn't that pretty much the end of the road? Internal bleeding, infection, lights out. Well... I have med packs. I don't know. No? Nice of you to lie, Doc, but I know what's what. So, you've done all you can for Captain Carlson. Death grasps at his soul. Okay, so is there no point in healing him? Does that do nothing? Feeling any better? Okay, I guess that's all I can do. Alright, what exactly am I supposed to do with the perimeter? Just kill the dogs or something else? Close any holes? Need to find a supply of building materials and use it to patch the weak points. Okay. Alright, let's check the parameter. Well, there's the building supplies. These are probably going to be heavy as hell. 15 pounds. Lexicanium, you suck, so why don't you take them? Thank you. Oh yeah, level up. Six points? Okay. What do we go with? Everything's pretty much... Actually, everything's exactly even. Discounting the leadership bonus. So, doesn't matter much, except... Of course I'm going to place a low priority on assault rifles, because that is, again, not this character's point. He's not mainly a combat character. Let's go with Kiss Ass. Six points? Okay. I don't really care about alarm disarming. Field medics covered by... Computer science and field medic are both covered by other people. Let's go with mechanical repair. One man's trash is another man's ammo and health packs. What is that? Camouflage bag hangs from a crane hook. You may be able to get it down with a well-placed shot. Cool! Lucky crit. What is that? I want to mouse over it, but I want to savor the moment because that looks incredibly cool, so it's probably going to be awesome. This is definitely a sniper's bag. Lots of medic stuff and then sniper ammo. Sabra Marie? Sabra? It is a sniper. It's got a massive variance in damage. From 10 to 98. Alright, hold on, let's see how this compares. Okay. Minimum damage is vastly lower, max damage is vastly higher, making the average about the same. Hit chance is about the same, critical chance is the same, multiplier is a little bit higher. Oh my god, look at the range on the M24. Although, a lot of that has to do with the long barrel. And the high-powered scope. Higher armor penetration. Only costs 5 AP for a single shot. I have no idea if that's actually better. It means that shots are less dependable because of the huge variance in damage. I mean, the average is about... Well, it's a little bit higher than 50 is the average, so actually, on average, it will do more damage than the M24. I think I might use it, but how much of this ammo do I have? That actually might be the only bit of that ammo that I have. Let's check it. 762. I think it is. Yeah, it is. Well, let's use it for... See, if I'm going to use it, though, I'm going to want to switch over all of my attachments. And removing all of these attachments. 100% chance it'll be recovered, so at least that part's good. Yes, there's a 100% chance of recovering everything, so I'm not going to lose any of these attachments, but that's a lot of work for only 6 shots, because I'm going to have to switch everything back once I run out of ammo, so I'm not going to do that yet. Alright, where exactly is the perimeter? Is it just this wall? I think it's this wall. In which case, I should probably be on the other side. Right? Should I be on the other side? I don't actually know. Hold on. Hold on, guys. Come back. Let's just advance more this way. I'm not really sure where the perimeter is. I mean, this is a wall. But... my third Kama Sutra book. Okay. Bad things. Probably a good place to look for parts of the wall missing. We can conserve our ammo here. Yeah, there's not too many. Actually, wait a minute, there's some more dogs hidden in the dark. 4 of them. Nah, we'll be fine. I'll just use single shot. Awfully fast, though. You pretty much get one free turn, and then they're moved into place to attack you. Maybe I should have burst it. I don't think I need a headshot. No, the minimum damage on this thing is 42. It has 43 hit points. Should kill it. Oh, come on. It's still significantly less damage. This is... it's actually unlikely to kill it. 37 to 48, and it has 43. Good headshot. That's a terrible chance to hit. Screw it. It's burst. It's only got one shot in the magazine. Guess I'll shoot it. Oh, here we go. Okay, yeah, so the wall is very, very far on the outskirts. Something to block it off. Let's go ahead and do that.
Echo 1, do you read me? Echo 1, come in.
We read you. Over.
10-4, Echo 1. Looks like I got this POS up and running at last. So you can get an idea what's out there, I'm gonna start patching through local broadcasts as I find them. Got your first one coming in now. This is that nut job we were picking up back in Arizona. His name's Matthias.
Downtrodden of Los Angeles. This is Matthias speaking. Let me help you. I know how hard your life is. Your muscles ache. Your bones break. Disease weakens you. And you have nothing to look forward to as you grow older but pain and loneliness and death. But there is another way. I am 200 years old, friends. I was born before the apocalypse. And nearly died in its flames, until the Guardians rescued me and placed my consciousness into an ever-living plastic and metal body. Now, I am immortal. I feel no pain. I fear no disease. And I'm one with my brothers and sisters in the Citadel, always and forever. This is the gift I want to pass on to you. The weak, the downtrodden, the persecuted, and the enslaved. Come to the new Citadel. Join our Brotherhood. And you too will wear the armor of the Guardians. You too will be immortal, invulnerable, untouched by disease or age for all time. You will be a perfect being, ready to lead the world into a golden future of light, beauty, and unceasing joy.
That's interesting. He said the Guardians placed his, what, his mind, his consciousness, basically placed him inside of the body of metal and plastic. And now he's 200 years old. He said the Guardians did this. He's almost talking about them as if they're his gods. Or his god or gods. Almost as if he's subservient to them. Almost like he doesn't necessarily believe he's special. More he's acting to support the Guardians, acting to their cause. More of a willing and proud puppet of the Guardians. So it makes me wonder who the Guardians are. And why would they save him? Why? What's special about him? Alright, so we have, what, 4 more pieces of wood? Yeah, so there's probably 4 more holes. Let's go look for them.
Copy, Ranger Team Echo. And congratulations, Echo 1.
That was Helen. How you doing? 3 points, not enough. I love the look of this place. Just very different from what I saw from the last zone. Some cool little details too, like this cloth here, blowing in the wind. A decent amount of ammo for that new sniper rifle that I just found. Might be worth it to switch over. A law rocket, nice. Those things are expensive to buy, and extremely heavy. It's a pair of engagement rings. It gives you less action points, but much more combat initiative. Interesting. That sounds terrible, but that's actually very powerful. That's actually very powerful. Plus 3 combat initiative is very good. Yeah, that would be especially good for a sniper. And the reason for that, I mean, okay, look at this. Let's see. Yeah, so if I put 1 more point into awareness, it gives me 1 combat initiative, another 1 plus 2, another 1 plus 3. So basically, 1 attribute point can give you at most 1 combat initiative, and this one gives you plus 3. Now, the negative to your action points sounds really bad, but with somebody like a sniper, who doesn't really need to move for the most part, they're kind of fixed in a fixed position. For that sort of a person, like, once you take 1 shot with your sniper rifle, chances are that's all you're going to do for the turn. So if you normally have AP left over, then the negative 1 action point is not really a big deal, and the plus 3 combat initiative is a lot of combat initiative, which means you're going to get to take your turn a lot more often. So that's pretty freaking sweet. But then again, White Death is also pretty freaking sweet. Plus 5% ranged hit bonus, that's good. The plus 2 combat initiative would be more important during a long fight. For a short fight of only a couple turns, I think that White Death is probably better. Because the combat initiative thing is pretty much irrelevant in a very short fight. It's cumulative over time. So over a long fight, you're going to get a lot more use out of it. I hear doggies. Nuts. Everybody loves cashews. Alright, there's probably a bunch more dogs in the dark. There's a ridge there I can't go around. Wait, this is the shortest route back to there? Where are you going? This is the shortest route over that little ridge. Really? Okay. If the pathfinding says so, I will I guess, I'm not sure what the right word is. I will trust it. I guess you couldn't go in between any of these. A little bit sooner than I wanted that encounter to begin, but we should be fine. Okay, so I know they're gonna come on hard and fast, so let's burst them, even if it is a little bit wasteful of ammo. 43%, that's freaking horrible. Let's just ambush. Punch that dog to death for me, Lexicanium. Thank you, sir. Pew! Okay, there's not too many of them left. I think just that one, so we can go easy on the amp. Go. Excuse me, holy crap, something got stuck in my throat. Oh, we can go easy on the ammo, so let's see. Shotgun it, that's the cheapest. Yeah, let's just shotgun it. And then. Punch it. 74% chance, come on! Come on! Ah. Lexicanium is actually being slightly useful. It's amazing.
Echo 1, this is Santa Fe Base.
Roger, Santa Fe Base. This is Echo 1. Over.
Got another patch through for you. These jokers are the God's Militia. The other group we picked up back in Arizona. Sounds like a charming bunch.
Let us talk today about sin, brothers and sisters. I know all of you out there in the cesspit you call Hollywood think that we up here on the hill believe ourselves better in you, that we think you down there are all sinners, and we up here are all saints. Well, friends, nothing could be further from the truth.
Echo 1, this is Santa Fe Base. Picking up a new frequency. This gang seems to have a pretty powerful transmitter. Might be worthwhile checking out, but, well, they sure are a bit strange.
More strange than the others?
They're called the Mannerites. Patching in now.
Mannerites. Does that mean they're obsessed with manners? Like, table manners?
Hello, Los Angeles. Today, with your kind permission,
I'd like to
put aside our usual call-in format and talk to you about what we're up to down here at the Angel Oracle. Some see our grand edifice and wonder if we're a cult. Some see our martial politeness patrols and wonder if we're a gang. Others express confusion about our message, mistaking our civility and gentility for pacifism. Well, let me put all that to rest. We are not a cult. We are not a gang. And while it is true that we try to be kind and considerate people, that does not mean we let the uncouth and ungracious walk all over us. That kind of rudeness will not be tolerated, and we have the guns to express our disapproval in the strongest terms. Our message is quite simple, really. Etiquette is the soul of civilization. It's easy to forget that we're all just trying the best we can in this fallen world. When you let go of your manners, you become little better than a beast. And I assure you, if you act like a beast, we will be glad to treat you as one. We hope, however, that you won't, because we care about you, Los Angeles. We really do. That's why we want to invite you to come down to the Angel Oracle and see our better way. We refuse to let the end of civilization be an excuse for a lack of civilization. Don't let fear make you a monster. Join us, and we'll teach you how to politely show fear the door and never invite it back. Right. That's all for now. Tune in soon for our next show, in which we'll be returning to our regular call-in format. In the meantime, I wish you the very best. Stay polite, Los Angeles.
Well, that was strange. It seems like they're the kind of people that would, like, flash a bright smile and just be kind and warm up until the moment that they shoot you in the face with a shotgun. Or stab you in the back with a knife. It's the creepy, insidious kind of politeness. The kind of politeness that you always think just hides something really rotten underneath.
Copy, Ray.
See, three dogs. Ambush? I mean, well, I'm gonna ambush, but do I want to burst? Not really. Make that two dogs. Nine hit points. Let's go ahead and punch you.
Copy, Ray. Echo, congratulations.
Eight points. Nice. Okay, energy weapons is good, so it's going to be submachine gun, smart ass, or perception. Well, definitely not perception, because Helen's got perception. So, submachine gun or smart ass? Let's go smart ass. I want to get those speech skills up, because if I don't have them during a kind of pivotal conversation, then I'm going to really regret it. Should be one more thing to patch up after this one. I have one unit of woods left.
Echo One, this is Santa Fe Base. Found another frequency. Don't know who this crankcase is, but he sure as shit has a mad on for Matthias. Near as I can tell, his name is Dugan. Patching in now.
Pathetic meatbags of Los Angeles, listen to your overlord. No one can save you from being ground beneath the iron-shod feet of my robot army. The Mannerites cannot save you. The God's militia cannot save you. And that lying half-man who calls himself Matthias certainly cannot save you. Only immediate and total obedience to my commands will spare you the fate that awaits the rest of humanity. Its utter and complete destruction. I, Dugan, shall rule.
Oh crap, I didn't mean to get into an encounter. Damn it, it's not the radio message. I wanted to hear the rest of that. I was trying to move them over here because this is a really bad position to kill these dogs from. But when I clicked over here, they started to run the shortest path there, which is through the dogs, and then the dogs found me. So, oh well. There's actually a lot of dogs, so let's go ahead and switch to burst fire and ambush. For some reason, I thought this dog was wounded. I would have burst fired it if I'd actually realized that. Whoops. Oh, that's the one that was wounded. God damn it, I shot the wrong one. Oh well. Let's see, I could punch it. Let's shotgun it. Yeah.
Congratulations.
5 points, not quite enough. Okay, that should do it. Should be the last hole, and this place should be secured.
Echo One, this is Santa Fe Base. Go ahead.
We have secured the perimeter. Over.
10-4, Echo One. Perimeter secured. Well done. That'll make it a whole lot more likely we'll still be here when the support team shows up. If they ever do. Listen, Echo One, one more thing. I think Captain Carlson is getting pretty close to a retirement. You might want to return to base before he goes. Santa Fe Base out.
I would just like to point out that while that man is dying and waiting for me to return, I'm digging up a hole to look for loot. I'm that sort of a person. You know, I probably should actually return, because it might actually be time limited, so let's go back. Hello there. You got full health, man. I'm still not convinced you're actually gonna die. About time you closed those gaps. Wasn't sure I was gonna hold on till you were through. Now, anything you want to ask before I cash in my chips? Our mission here in Los Angeles, for instance, or maybe you want to know about our chopper going down in Seal Beach and the whole crew with it? Oh, is this the sort of thing where it's like I can only ask one or two questions before he dies, so I need to pick which one I think is most important? Let's assume it is. What's the mission? Pretty basic. First off, you're going to need to upgrade your rad suits in order to make your way around California, so ask Woodson for the details. Second, hook up a repeater unit to the radio tower at Griffith, so that we can re-establish contact with Citadel Base. Third, find out what you can about the broadcast we heard back in Arizona, and determine their threat level. Fourth, find a way to get to Seal Beach, find out what happened to Team Foxtrot, and get the bastards who did it. And last but not least, help the locals, and spread the name and fame of the Desert Rangers. Let the people know that we're a force for good in this rotten world. Okay, gotcha. What happened to the chopper crew? I'm guessing they're all dead. Tried to raise the downed chopper on the radio. No answer. Not a goddamn peep. What do you know about Seal Beach? Heard the same thing you heard in Arizona. The flyover, the robots, the missile. Sent a team south on foot to try to find them. Ran into heavy radiation. Had to turn back. Maybe you'll find some way through. We didn't get the chance. How strong is the radiation? Strong. Even with the rad suits Captain Mercaptain provided, the radiation was too intense. You're gonna need to re-establish contact with Ranger Citadel and talk to Mercaptain in order to figure out a new plan. Okay. What about the missile? I'm afraid I don't know any more than you do. I thought all the missiles were used up in the war. And the robots? They're ruthless. Even more so than humans. You gotta find out what their game is, or what their end game is. I think he's about to die. Hang on, killer, just... Sorry, boys, think I'm checking out. It's like, oh, damn it. Put me in the same grave as my men. We died together. Oh. Adios. And I never got to read what the last sentence was. It's a sad day, Rangers. Never knew a man more alive than old Killer Carlson. Damn. Listen, I'll take care of burying him and all that. Carlson gave you your marching orders before he died. So let's get to it. You need to hook up a repeater unit to the radio tower in Griffith. It's the strongest signal in the region. We need it in order to reach Citadel back in Arizona. Unfortunately, Griffith lies beyond the northern radiation wall, and your rat suits just aren't going to cut it. Before we left Arizona, Mercaptain taught me a technique to upgrade rat suits using cat litter. I'm going to need as much cat litter as you can find. To be precise, I need at least 56 pounds of it. That's roughly 7 bags of litter. what? Okay. Getting to that tower and reestablishing comms to Ranger Citadel is the... Is the key reaching Seal Beach. Okay, let me just rewrite that in my mind. Getting to that tower and reestablishing comms with Ranger Citadel is the key to reaching Seal Beach and finding out what happened to Foxtrot Team. Seal Beach lies beyond the southern radiation wall, which has even more intense radiation than the northern wall. Mercaptain mentioned that for radiation levels that deadly, we'd need to get our hands on some medical-grade zeolite. Not the low-grade stuff you find in cat litter. Lucky for us, we've been hearing some radio chatter from Griffith from a group that calls themselves the God's Militia, and it sounds like they're stockpiling zeolite for themselves. You'd already be in the neighborhood, so if you could strike a bargain with them for some zeolite, You'd be killing two birds with one stone. I just need to discuss the details with Mer-Captain so I can upgrade your rad suits with the good stuff and send you safely past the southern radiation wall. All the meanwhile, you'll need to keep tracking down all the other crazies behind the broadcasts we've been getting and assess their threat level. And last but not least, help the locals and spread the name and fame of the Desert Rangers. I know that's asking a lot of you, Echo Team, but Rangers don't complain. We just get the job done. Before you go, you're gonna need these. The key I gave you will unlock the chains on the southern gate. Don't lose it. That's the only spare copy I have. I'll make sure to lock up after you're gone. Wouldn't want any more dogs to get in. I give you a total of 3 repeater units. You only need 1 for the tower in Griffith, but if you can hook up the other 2 to any of the local transmitters in the area, it would help boost our local broadcasting range, and let even more people know that we're here to help. Speaking of which, before you wander too far away, let's do a radio check a couple of miles out. If we've got a good enough signal, I'll start letting LA know we're here and ready to help. Alright, what do you know about the locals so far? We passed over lots of small farms and communities as we flew into LA, all heavily fortified. If they're building walls, then they're defending themselves against something. And if they're defending themselves against something, we've got a job to do. I'll call you as soon as I start picking up distress calls. Until then, just get out there and do your best for whoever you meet. Alright, what crazies do you mean? He must be talking about the different gods, militia, and whatnot. Sadly, the strongest signal seems to be coming from the most dangerous-sounding camp, those god militia people to the north of here. Then we have those broadcasts from Matthias, Dugan and the Mannerites, and Heidi from Hollywood. Where should we look for the remains of Foxtrot, team? We just talked about that, didn't we? Seal Beach? Yeah, Seal Beach. Mm-hmm. Okay, so about the cat litter. I know. Cat litter contains zeolite, which can be used to soak up radiation from air as it passes through it. It will be perfect for your breathing masks. Just try to get unused litter, if you can. That sounds good. Echo 1 reporting. Oh, I guess we got a couple levels up from the XP. Alright. We have a lot of work to do. I wonder if you can actually use cat litter to soak up radiation. I mean, at first it sounds ridiculous, but it actually might be plausible. Because I know cat litter is often used to soak up, like, what, oil and stuff like that? So apparently it is very good at absorbing and containing bad, you know, bad chemicals and stuff. But radiation? I don't know, radiation isn't a liquid. So, I don't know. Okay, who leveled up? Theodore? 3 points, not enough. Luxcanium? 5 points, not enough. Okay, well, we definitely have our marching orders. Hell of a lot of quests. And on this huge map, we have only been here. It's a lot to check out. Okay, well, I think I will end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.